every time they say the train stopped, we were hoping that the situation or the end of the journey has arrived, which it never did. It just seemed to have gone on, for ages. But the next thing I do remember was then suddenly we arrived at place people, loads of dogs, loads of guards, and people with a lot of people with striped uniforms on, and kept on shouting in Yiddish, which fortunately we spoke, as I said earlier, saying that eat up all your food, don't save any food, eat up all your food, and the children must say you're older than you are, you must say you're older than you are. And of course it stuck in our mind about that. But also the next thing of course I remember is that suddenly the train stopped. A lot of commotion going on and a lot of banging on the door, and the doors weren't opened. Some doors were open, some were not. And of course people thought that what they'll do, they say there are a lot of people in here who are not well, who are ill, thinking that the doors would open quicker. But needless to say, the more people shouted there are sick people here, the more the door stayed locked. And then eventually somebody said, look, it's silly, you could see that the doors are not being opened, don't say that people are here are ill. There were some people that experienced from the First World War some sort of internment, either prisoners of war or they realized the situation was happening. And eventually the door was opened and we literally fell out, literally stumbled out from there.